Welcome back to Mr. Spellum's Math Tutorials. Today we're tasked to identify the properties of an isosceles trapezoid, so please stay tuned. Alright, let's go ahead and get started. Here we have an isosceles trapezoid. It's isosceles because these two sides here called legs are congruent, so this left-hand side is congruent to this right-hand side. Also, we know that the angles at the base here at the bottom are congruent, so this angle is congruent to this angle. Matter of fact, let's go ahead and label this trapezoid. So we're going to call this A, B, C, D. So again, we said that angle D is congruent to angle C. We also know that angle A up here at the top is congruent to angle B. So we use this marking here to show that. We also know that the sum of angle A and angle D is 180 degrees, so they're supplementary. So angle A plus angle D is 180 degrees. We also know that angle B, which is this angle here, plus angle D is also 180 degrees. And we have a similar situation here on the right where we're going to take angle B and add that to angle C. That there also gives us 180 degrees. We can also add angle A to angle C, and again we end up with 180 degrees. We can also label the top and bottom the bases. So here, base 1 and base 2. We know that these are the bases because they are the parallel lines. So I have one set of parallels here, the top and the bottom. We can also talk about the mid segment or the median. Well, the mid segment or the median is going to be the line that goes from the midpoint of BC and the midpoint of AD, and that line that connects them is called the mid segment or median. And we have an expression for that. That expression is the average of base 1 and base 2. So if we take base sub 1 plus base sub 2 and we divide that by 2, that there gives us our median, also known as our mid segment. All right, let's spell this mid segment. All right, and the last thing I want to talk about here are the diagonals. So if we have a diagonal going here from angle D to angle B, and another diagonal from angle A to angle C, those diagonals are congruent. So here we can write this as AC is congruent to BD. All right, well, that sums up this tutorial. If you like it, please like it. And as always, thank you for watching.